student, today we are going to start your new chapter. It's chapter number 17 of class 7th and the name of your chapter is Forest, Our Lifeline. As the name suggests, in this chapter we are going to uncover the main principles behind the main principle of environment related to this forest, okay? So where various terms related to the forest and what are the various processes which are going on in the forest, okay? So let's begin our chapter by reading. One evening, Bujo entered in the park with the elderly person he introduced him to his friend, okay? Professor Ahmed was a scientist working in the university. The children started playing while Professor Ahmed sat on a bench in the corner. He was tired as he had participated in the Golden Jubilee celebration of the town, okay? So after a while, the children also came and sat around him. They wanted to know about the celebration. So Professor Ahmed told them that after the cultural program, the senior people discussed the town's unemployment problem. Okay, unemployment is the condition in which a particular person is not working. Okay, a plan was proposed to put up a factory by clearing an area of the forest just outside the town. So what was the problem? What was the problem faced by the people that the particular area has been proposed to put up a factory by cutting down of the trees? This would give the increasing population of the town a chance to get the jobs. So there is a dilemma. There is a particular condition in which two main problems are facing each other. If they cut down the plant, it will harm the environment. But if they will not cut down the plants, they will not have enough place to make the factory, and that will help for the unemployed people to get the job. So this is the problem. Children were very surprised when Professor Ahmed told them that many people had objected to this idea. Many people were against of this idea. Children were very surprised, so they asked Professor Ahmed why is it so. This is because the forest serves as green lungs. Here, forest has been said as green lungs. Why they are called as green lungs? Because forest provides us oxygen by the process of photosynthesis. We know the process of photosynthesis. In class 6, in class 7th also we read about photosynthesis. The product of photosynthesis is oxygen. So more plants is equal to more oxygen. So in other language we can say that forests are nothing but green lungs which provide us oxygen, more respiration and more good for us. And water purifying systems in nature, they also purify the water, okay? More forest, more trees also play significant role in water cycle, in rain also, okay? Professor Ahmed explained, the children were confused. Professor Ahmed realized that children had not visited a forest, okay? The children also wanted to know more about forest, so they decided to visit a forest with Professor Ahmed. So here is the description of their visit to that forest. One Sunday morning, children packed a few things like knife, hand lens, stick, notebook and book together to the forest trail near a village. Okay. On their way, they met Tibu, a young boy of their age group of nearby village who was taking cattle for grazing. Okay. Along with his aunt. He was very agile, running here and there to keep the hut together. Okay? While he saw the children, Tibu also started walking along with them while his aunt went to the different path. As soon as they entered the forest, Tibu raised his hand and signaled them to keep quiet because noise could disturb the animal living in the forest. So what is the first rule to enter in the forest? Not to make noise, to be quiet. Otherwise, you will be disturbing all the animals because forest is the natural habitat of those animals and you are entering in their habitat. So you should follow their rule. You should not make noise, okay? So next is, Tibu then took them to the place at the height to show them the broad view of that forest. Children were surprised because they could not see any land in that area. The different tree tops had formed green cover over the land. However, the cover was not uniformly green. Okay? So, the children could not see the land because the entire land growing, this made children quite fresh and happy. And the whole environment is different from the environment in which those children are living. Okay? While coming down, they excited on hearing a sudden sound of birds and some noises from top branches of the tree. Tibu told them to relax since it was normal phenomena here. What is the normal phenomena in the forest? The chirping voice of the birds and the other animals, the voice of other animals, okay? Because of children's presence, some monkeys are climbing higher up on the trees where they disturb the bird, okay? So, because of the presence of the children, now monkeys climbed up higher and on higher branches, because that bird made their nest on the higher branches, now those monkeys are disturbing those birds, that's why they are chirping more. Tibu also told them that many animals like boar, bison, jackal, porcupine, elephants live in the deeper area of the forest. So you should know the name of these animals which live in the deeper area of the forest. Okay, Professor Ahmed cautioned children that they should not go deep into the forest because these animals can harm children. That's why he advised them not to go in the deep area. Bhuja and Pahli remember that they have studied about forest as an example of habitat in class 6. We have studied about it, right? They could now see how the forest provides home for many animals and a plant. So basically till here, it is the entire forest has been taken as the habitat for various plants, various trees and various animals also. And one thing is also mentioned, in the deep of this forest, many type of animals are present. Examples have been given. Jackal, porcupine, elephants, they live deep inside the forest, okay? And bird make their nest at the higher level of the tree. Okay, 2-3 things has been given till now. Let us see. Now these are the picture of few plants in the forest. Neem plant, then shisham, then this is shimal and this is bamboo tree, okay? The land where the children were walking was uneven and covered with many trees. Land is uneven and covered with many trees. Tibu helped them to identify sal, teak, simal, shisham, neem, palash, fig, khair, amla, then bamboo and kachna. Okay, Professor Ahmed pointed out that there are several other trees which are shrub, herb and grasses in the forest. So forest is having different kind of trees. Forest is having different kind of plants. Big trees are there, then shrubs are there, herbs are there. So Professor Ahmed told them forest is made up of different type of trees. Okay, now in the forest the trees was also covered with different types of creeper and climber. Creeper and climbers were also present in forest area. The sun was barely visible through the leaves of the tree, making it quite dark inside the forest. Why forest seem as dark even in the bright sunlight? Because of the branched trees, the sunlight cannot get into the deep of that forest. That's why forest appear dark even in the bright sunlight. Even in the daytime, forest appear dark because the leaves of the branched tree, they will not allow light to get into the deep, that ground level of that forest. That's why forest appear dark even in the sunlight. Okay, now activity 17.1, observe various things in your home and make a list of those which are made from material which may have been obtained from the forest. You might have many wooden items, your furniture, your fuel, your wooden box, then paper, matchstick and furniture. All those things are made up of wood, and we obtain wood from trees. And where we find these trees in that large number? Forest. Do you know that gum, oil, spices, fodder for animal and medicinal plants are also some of the product which you get from the forest? Yes, it's true. Okay. Now, Sheila wondered who would have planted this tree. Sheila is wondering who has planted this huge number of trees. Professor Ahmed replied that in nature trees produce enough seed. In nature trees are having enough seed. Okay, nobody go to the forest and they sow the seed. No, this thing not happen in forest. But will happen, the forest floor provide favorable sunlight, and nutrient is also there because the forest is rich in the trees. That's why enough nutrients was also present in that soil, and this condition is favorable for all the seeds, and they will germinate more easily as we compare it with other land area. So forest area will provide enough nutrient, enough water supply is there, and enough land is there. That's why more trees will be planted by most of the trees will be planted by their own. Okay, so they can floor provide favorable condition for them to germinate and develop into seedling. These are the product of forest: honey, then wooden statue, sealing wax, then gum, then statue, and sapling. Some grow into trees. He added that branchy part of the tree above the stem, from where the branching starts. That part is known as crown of the tree. And different trees are having different type of crown. You know that different trees are having different type of crown. What is crown? The area from where the branching start. For example, this plant, this is the crown of this plant, this is the crown of this plant, this is crown of this, and respective plants. Okay, so different plants are having different shape of the crown and different width of the crown. Okay, different depth of the crown. So different kind of plants are having different kind of crowns, right? Professor Ahmed asked children to look up and observe how the branches of the trees, tall tree, look like a roof over the other plant. Okay, because some plants are having higher height as larger height as compared to other plants, so their canopy will cover. This crown will cover the different plants which are shorter than those plants. This is known as canopy. What is canopy? Because different plants are having different kind of height and different kind of crown. So some trees which are having longer height as compared to other, they will cover other plants in their shadow, in their crown, and this is known as canopy. Okay, the different height of the trees in the forest is known as canopy. You can see that canopy thing in this figure also, which we have just seen. This figure, different type of trees are having different type of crowns. So for example, if this tree is having longer height than other, then it will cover few other trees over it. So when we see it from the sky, we will see the roof like structure. The trees will form roof like structure. That's why sunlight is not going deep inside that forest. Okay, now activity 17.2. Visit a forest or a park in your neighborhood. Observe the trees and try to identify them. You can take the help of some elders or book on trees. List the characteristics of the tree that you observe, such as height, shape of leaves, crown, flower, fruit. Also draw the crown of some trees. You will see different type of trees will have different kind of crown. Okay. Professor Ahmed pointed out that trees had crowns of different height, different type and sizes. These had created different horizontal layer in the forest. Okay, different horizontal layer. You can imagine one tree is of this height, another of this height, another of this height. So different horizontal layers has been created by the crown of these trees. Okay, these are known as understory. Okay, what is the two term we have learned so far? First one is canopy. What is canopy? The covering of higher plant, of taller plant, over the forest area is canopy. And understory is the horizontal layer that has been created by the plants due to different types and sizes. That is understory. Giant and tall plant constitute the top layer. Okay, so entire forest can be divided into several layers. The very first layer will be of tall trees. Okay, the first layer of the forest will be tall trees. Giant and tall trees constitute the top layer, followed by then shrub. Okay, then tall grasses, then herb will form the lowest layer. And different type of animal and birds are present in different layers. So four layer has been discussed so far. First layer consists of giant and tall trees. Second layer consists of shrub trees, okay, shrub plants, I'm sorry. Then third layer, tall grasses like bamboo, then herb, and then small grasses, herb like grasses, okay. So different kind of, like for example, insect will be that the habitat of insect will be on herb, okay. And on the topmost giant and tall plants, birds would have made their nest. Okay, so different type of plant, different type of animal and birds make their habitat on different layer of this understory. Okay, would we see similar kind of trees in every forest? No, ask Bujo. No, due to different climatic condition, there will be variety in the types of trees in each type of forest. Okay, the types of animal also differ from forest to forest because different trees will be there. So the animal which will be depending on different trees, they will be differ in different kind of forest. So this is the canopy, okay, and this is the understory. What is understory? The difference is the height, the layers are formed by the different height. And what is the canopy? Canopy is the that covering of tall plants and shadowing of other plant by the tall plant because of the branched that crown of that taller plants. Okay, so a few children are busy watching beautiful butterflies fluttering here and there on the flowers of shrub and herb. They had a close look at the bushes also. While doing that, their hair and clothes had seeds and shrub clinging on them. They came across numerous insects also, spiders, squirrels, ants, and various other small animals, okay, on the bark of the tree. Plant leaves and all decaying leaves on the forest floor. They saw many type of insects, many type of animals, and even dead and decaying leaves also on the floor. They started making sketches of these creatures. The forest floor seemed dark colored and was covered with a layer of dead and decaying leaves, fruit, seeds, twigs, and small herbs. Okay, the decaying matter was moist and warm because of rain. Okay, because of presence of water, the moist floor, the floor of dead and decaying leaves is moist and warm. Okay, children picked up different seeds and leaves for their collection. Walking over the dead leaf layer on the forest floor was like walking on a spongy carpet because that layer is moist and warm. Is the decaying matter was always warm? Professor Emma suggested that the children could perform an activity to get the answer. So let us see what activity they performed. For that, we could dig a small pit, put vegetable waste and leaves in it, cover it with soil, add some water, and after 3 days, remove that upper layer of the soil. Does the pit feel little warm? Paheli asked, there are so many trees here. Yes, it will feel warm because the process, this is the composting process which involves the digestion of that organic dead and decaying matter, and it will be converted into manure. Okay, so it will be warm. Paheli asked, there are so many trees here, also there are many forests like this. What difference will it make if we cut some trees for the factory? She was asking. Professor Ahmed said, you have read about autotroph, heterotroph, and saprotroph. Different trees play different role in the environment. If we cut one type of trees, it will affect the life of other trees also, because there is a link between all the life forms in the nature. Let us find out what is it. You have learned how green plant produce food. We know that green plant produce food. All the animals, whether herbivores or carnivores, depend ultimately on the green plant for food. How? All the herbivores will be feeding on green plants directly, but carnivores will be feeding on herbivores, and herbivores are depending on green plant. So both herbivores and carnivores will ultimately be depending on green plant only, right? So organisms which feed on plant often get eaten by other organisms and so on. Example, let us see example. We are unfolding very important phenomena of nature, so listen carefully. Just imagine grass which is eaten by one insect. That insect is eaten by frog. Frog is consumed by snake. So a linear chain is formed by this. Grass eaten by insect, insect eaten by frog, frog eaten by snake, snake eaten by this eagle. So this is known as food chain. Because it is linear, that's why chain and by food, because different kind of animal will be depending on different kind of animal. That's why it is a food chain for their food. They are depending on each other for the food. So suppose if we remove the grass, insect will die. If insect will die, frog will die. Frog will die, snake will die. And if snake will die, then eagle will die. So the entire chain will be broken. Same thing happen if we cut few trees. Because on that tree, maybe few animals will be depending on that tree. So we cannot remove even a single organism or a single plant from the nature. It will disturb the whole nature. Many food chain can be found in the forest. Okay? Different kind of food chain will be there in the forest. For example, grass eaten by deer. Deer will be eaten by tiger. This is another kind of food chain. Okay? In nature, actually, food chain is not there. Many food chain intermingle with each other and will form food web. For example, here you can see grass is eaten by insect also, and grass is eaten by deer also. Deer ultimately will be eaten by you can say jackal. Jackal will be eaten by some other animal. So there is intermingling or interdependent of one chain into another. Okay, so it is known as food web. All the food chain are linked. If any one food chain is disturbed, it affects on other food chain also. Every part of forest is depending on other part. That's why each and every plant is important. If we remove one component, say tree, all other component will be affected. They will not get the prime source of food. Okay? Professor Ahmed asked children to pick up leaves from the forest floor and observe them under the hand legs. They found tiny mushroom over those. They found tiny mushroom over those decaying leaves. They also saw many army of the insect, millipedes, and ant and beetle on them. What was that? They were wondering how this organism lived there. Professor Ahmed explained, apart from these animals which are easily seen, many more small microorganisms are also there which we cannot see with our naked eyes, which are present in the soil. What is the work of that microorganism? They actually eat up all the dead and decaying matter and convert that dead and decaying matter into manure, into compost for other plants. That's why forest is rich in the flora and fauna both, because it is having enough nutrient. The moment the tree that shed its leaves or any animal or anything die in the forest, the microorganism will feed on that particular dead and decaying matter and it will convert it into manure. That's why forest area is rich in manure. Okay? Now, so Pahili wondered what mushroom and other microorganism eat. Professor Ahmed replied that they feed on dead plant and animal tissue and convert them into dark color substance known as humus. Okay? You have learned about humus in chapter 9. In which layer of the soil would you find a humus? I hope you remember. We will find the humus in the top layer. Okay, horizon A. I hope you remember. What is this important to the soil? It will provide the fertility to the soil. Okay, the microorganism which convert that plant and animal to the humus are known as decomposers. Okay. This microorganism played important role in the forest. Soon, Pahili removed some dead leaves and discovered under the layer a layer of humus on the forest floor. The presence of humus ensures that enough nutrients are there, so they can be reabsorbed by the plant for their growth. Okay? What happens if the animal dies in the forest? Same thing happens. It will be eaten up by the microorganism. First of all, there will be the food for vultures, crow, jackal, and insect. In this way, the nutrients are cycled. When some animal or plant will die, it will be eaten up by a different kind of animal and they will provide the nutrient back to the soil. So that cycle will go on. So nothing goes waste in the forest. Ultimately, nothing will go waste in the forest because it will be eaten up by different kind of animal. Okay? Pahili reminded Professor Ahmed not explain why forests are called green lungs. Now you will see why forests are known as green lungs. Professor Ahmed explains that plant release oxygen through the process of photosynthesis, right? Plant help to provide oxygen for animal for the respiration. We all the animals need oxygen for respiration. They also maintain the balance of oxygen and carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. That's why they are known as lungs and green. Why? Because they are green in color. Paheli reminded their friend that they have studied photosynthesis in chapter 1. Okay, so this is the balance of oxygen and carbon dioxide. Plant will release oxygen which is used by animal, but animal in turn give carbon dioxide to the plant for photosynthesis. So there is a cycle between these two gases. The children saw cloud forming in the sky. Bujo recalled that he had learned about what water cycling in class 6, right? Trees taken in the water from their roots and release water vapor into air through evaporation. If there were few trees, how will that water cycle will be affected? It will be affected. Less trees means less that water available for this clouds to be formed, and less rain will be there. Tibo told them that forest is not just home for plant and animal. Many people also live there. Some of them may belong to different tribe. Tibo explained that these people depend mostly on the forest. The forest provide various things like food, shelter, water and medicine. In turn, in return, these people protect the forest. Okay, they have traditional knowledge about many medicinal plants in the forest. They know about the forest more than us. While Bujo was drinking water from the small stream, he saw some deer crossing the stream. They disappear into bushes. The dense bushes and the tall tree provide animal with food and the shelter and protection also. They also protect them from carnivores that live in the forest. Okay, so now Paheli remember that she saw a peepal sapling on the side road of her school. Can you help her to understand how this would happen? Obviously, because that part is providing enough nutrients, that's why peepal sapling is there. Tibu then started looking closely at the forest floor. Soon he called and showed the children dropping of some animal and explained the difference between the various droppings. Various animals will be having different kind of dropping. Professor Ahmed informed that forest officer could recognize the presence of some animal in the forest by the dropping in the footprint. How forest officers detect the presence of different kind of animal? How do they know about different kind of animal? Every time they cannot search those animals because they will be hiding inside the deep layer of this forest. So by their droppings and their footprint, forest officer get to know about different presence of different kind of animals in that forest area. Bujo called everyone and showed them large decaying heap of animal dropping. Several beetle and grubs were feeding on heap and bunch of this seedling were sprouting, because that heap of this dropping is nothing but nutrient rich thing for many that plants. Okay, it's rich in nutrients, so seedling will be sprouting. These seedlings are of herbs and shrubs. The animals also disperse the seed of certain plant with the help of, and help the forest to grow. Okay, the animals, mostly animals having sticky legs, so what will they do? Some seed will be stick on their body, and when they will move, they will disperse that seed and entire forest will grow like that. Tibu then started looking closely at the forest floor. Soon he called and showed children dropping. Okay, we already did this part. Dropping of some animal and explain the difference. Okay, we have covered this part. Okay, yes. So after listening to this, Bujo noted in his notebook, by harboring greater variety of plant, forests provide greater opportunity for food and habitat for different herbivores also and carnivores also. Larger number of herbivores means increased availability of food for the variety of carnivores. More trees, more herbivores. More herbivores means more carnivores. Okay, the wide variety of animals help the forest to regenerate and grow. Decomposers help in maintaining the supply of the nutrient because they will feed up all the dead and decaying matter. they will clean the entire forest and they will that provide the soil nutrient. Okay, therefore the forest is a dynamic living entity. Why? Because the waste so generated will be removed soon and everything is moving, everything will be depending on one another, right? Plants will be depending on animals for carbon dioxide, animal will be depending on plants for the oxygen, so there is a cycle between those two. Okay, and the entire waste will be fed up by decomposers. They will remove entire waste from the forest area. That's why a forest is known as dynamic living entity, full of life and vitality. Okay, vitality. It was about afternoon and children wanted to go back. Tibu suggested to take another route for going back. While they are going back, it started raining. However, surprisingly, they saw that raindrop were not hitting the forest floor directly because of the thick canopy. The uppermost layer of the forest canopy intercepted the flow of raindrop, and most of the water was coming down through the branches, and they get protected from that. Okay, the stem of the tree, from the leaves, it was dripping slowly over the branches of the shrub and the herb. They found that ground was still dry. Though it's raining, but ground was still dry because of the thick canopy of the tall tree. After about half an hour, the rain stopped. They noticed that the layer of dead leaves over the forest appeared wet, but water did not stagnate in the forest. Like this thing happens in the cities area, but this thing does not happen in a forest area. Buju thought that if it had rained so heavily in the town, it would have flooded the drains and roads, but this thing is not happening in the forest. Why? What would happen if the rain heavily in your town? Same thing will happen, the water will be stagnant in this condition. Professor Ahmed told them that the forest also acts as natural absorber of rainwater and allow it to seep. Okay, many holes are present in which insects are living. The water will be, the extra rainwater will be seep into those holes, and the groundwater level will be recharged by the same. It helps to maintain water table throughout the year. Forests not only help in the controlling of the flood, but also maintain the flow of water in the stream so that they will get enough supply of the water. On the other hand, if the trees are not present, what will happen? Rain hit the ground directly. It will make the upper layer, which is the most fertile layer, to move it with that rainwater. And what will happen? The result of it will be, firstly, soil will be infertile. Secondly, when there is no uppermost fertile soil, the water will keep on flowing, and that's why all the water bodies will be that get more water and result in floods. Okay, heavy rain may also damage the soil. Root of the tree normally bind the soil together, but in their absence, soil is washed away and eroded. This is known as soil erosion. Erosion, okay. Children spent an hour in Tibu's village on their way back. The weather of the village was quite pleasant. Villagers told them that due to surrounding forest, they received good rainfall. The air also remained cool. Noise pollution too is less because of the forest absorbed the noise of nearby highway also. Children learned about the history of the village. It surprised them that the village and the agriculture field of that area were created by after clearing the forest about 60 years ago. Okay, Tibu grandfather told them that when he was young, the village was not as large as it was now. Okay, it was also surrounded by forest. Construction of road, building industries, and increasing the amount of wood created pressure over the forest area. It started vanishing, which is not at all good. Okay, he was not happy that the forest adjoining their village is not regenerating and is on the verge of disappearing due to overgrazing of animal, industrialization. Okay, along with that, the cutting of the forest. Professor Ahmed said that if we did things wisely, we could have preserved the forest, which is beneficial for us and environment as well as they have developed. Okay, children prepared a few picture to show the consequences of such event. At the end of the visit, Professor Ahmed asked children to sum up the importance of the forest. The children wrote, forests provide us oxygen. They protect soil from the erosion. They provide habitat to many organisms and animals. Forests help in bringing of good rainfall also in neighboring area. They are source of medicinal plant also, timber and many other useful product. Okay, that's why we must preserve forest. Okay, what would happen if forest disappear? We will not get enough oxygen. Water cycle will be disturbed. Okay, will not get the forest product also, and entire food cycle will be disturbed. You can see, if forest disappear, amount of carbon dioxide in the air will increase, resulting in increasing of earth temperature, which is known as global warming. In the absence of tree and plant, animal will not get enough food and shelter. In the absence of trees, soil will not hold water, which will cause flood. Deforestation will endanger our life and environment. So, think what we can do to preserve forests. So, that's why we need to preserve the forests, okay? So, chapter is over. Let's do the NCERT part. Explain how animal dwelling in the forest help it to grow and regenerate. The seed will be stick to their body and they will help to spread out their seed in the large area. That's how they will help in the dwelling. They will help in the growth and regeneration of the forest. Explain how forests prevent the flood. Forest means more trees. More trees means they will bind up the soil. And when they will bind up the soil, more surface is there which will help to seeping of that sea water. If forests are not there, the rain water will blow the layer of the soil along with that, and it will fill up the water bodies, which will cause flood. What are decomposers? Name any two of them. What do they do in the forest? You know the decomposers. Decomposers are the small microorganisms which feed on dead and decaying matter. The decomposers would be fungi. It could be small insect. Okay. And what do they do in the forest? They will clean the forest. How they clean the forest? They will eat up the dead and decaying matter, and it will convert them into manure. Explain the role of forest in the maintaining of balance between oxygen and carbon dioxide. We have already studied that part. You can refer. Explain why there is no waste in the forest. The entire waste has been converted into compost by the decomposers. List 5 products that we get from our forest. You can write your own things. Honey, then timber, then wood, then oxygen also. We can include oxygen also, okay? And then gum, rubber, various things we get from forest. Fill ups. Insect, butterfly, honeybees, bird help in flowering plant in germination, okay? And dispersal of seed also. Dispersal of seed basically help flowering plant in pollination. The proper term will be pollination and dispersal of seed. Forest is purifier of air and water. Herb form the dash layer, the fourth layer and the lowest layer of the forest. The decaying leaves and animal dropping in the forest enrich the manure to that forest, okay? It will enrich the forest floor with manure. Why should we worry about condition and issue related to forest far from us? Because they provide all the essential component to us. In addition to that, they also provide the oxygen, and we need oxygen for survival. Explain why there is a need of variety of animal and plant in the forest. Because in forest, cycle is maintained. If we remove even one component from that cycle, entire cycle will be disturbed. That's why all the components of the forest are essential. In figure 17.15, artist is forgotten to put the labels in the direction of the arrow. Mark the direction in the arrow and label the diagram using the following labels: cloud, rain, atmosphere, carbon dioxide, oxygen, plant, animal, soil, and root and water table. You can do that because we have already discussed the water cycle in our class 6th and 7th also. So you can do it by your own. Which of the following is not a forest product? So your answer would be kerosene. Okay. Which of the following statement is incorrect? Forest protect the soil from erosion. It is correct. Plant and animal in the forest are not dependent on each other. It is incorrect statement. So let's not go deep. So B is the option. Second, okay. Last question is, microorganism act on that plant to produce human. We will meet in our next video. Thank you for now.